And we're going to get started. Soles of our feet together, knees out wide. Starting to move down on our backs. Hi, Nancy. And before we do so, I'm going to go ahead and ring the gong. And again, allowing our shoulders to fall open with gravity as well. Starting to connect with the breath. Breathing into a four count. Holding to a four count. And exhaling to a four count. And as you breathe, breathe in through the belly, up through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to the tops of your throats. And then exhale in the opposite direction from the tops of your throats down through the ribs, the lungs, all the way to your bellies, as though you're wringing water from a washcloth, bringing navel into spine. Again, perhaps place your right hands on your bellies and your left hands on your hearts to track the breath as it moves through your bodies. And let's begin. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. And exhale, 2, 3, 4. Again, inhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. And exhale, 2, 3, 4. One more time, inhale, 2, 3, 4, hold, 2, 3, 4, and exhale, 2, 3, 4. Now allow your breathing to come naturally to its own rhythm. Allow the warmth of your breath to go to any area of your body that is tense or sore, and allow the breath to relieve the tension or soreness that is there. Imagine your breath gathering up all of the tension in your body and breathing it out so that you begin to feel peaceful and relaxed. Any distracting thoughts or feelings that you may have, allow them to be sent out with the breath. And as you breathe, allow yourselves to go deeper and deeper into this state of calm, knowing that you are in control at all times. Connect with a personal intention for this practice. That intention could be physical, mental, or spiritual, and it could be for you or for someone you love. Seal that intention with one deep inhale And one deep exhale. Good job. Inhale those knees and arms to center. Exhale as your knees fall to the left, arms to the right. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing into this simple twist. Opening up those right obliques as you do. And smile, it's Wednesday. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, knees to the right, arms to the left. Look over your left shoulder and breathe. Again, breathing in to this simple twist, opening up your left obliques as you do. Inhale, back to center. Wrap your arms around your knees. Grab opposite elbows, rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Then grab your insteps, drag your knees down towards your shoulder blades. Push up with your feet, pull down with your hands in happy baby. Rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys as you do. Job. And then from here, let's bend our knees, flex our feet, arms are out east and west, palms are down. Inhale first. Exhale as your legs fall down to the left, but don't touch. Keep those feet flexed. Inhale back to center. Exhale, down to the right, but don't touch. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, down to the left, but don't touch. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, down to the right, but don't touch. Two more or seven more, wherever you are. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Inhale to center, exhale to the left. Inhale to center, exhale to the right. If you're with us, four more. Inhale to center, exhale to the left. Inhale to center, exhale to the right. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. We're working those obliques as we do. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Two more. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. One more. Inhale to center. Exhale to the left. Inhale to center. Exhale to the right. Good job. Inhale back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. Inhale first. Exhale all the way down to the end of the mat. Roll over on to your left side. Left elbow, left palm of your hand down. Inhale that right knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. And again, drag that right shoulder back and down, breathing in and out. Grab onto your calf, drag your leg in even more. Again, in infinity pose, breathing in and out. Inhale, that right knee in. Exhale down to the end of the mat. Roll over onto your right side. Right elbow, right palm of your hand down. Inhale that left knee in. Grab your instep. Exhale, extend above you. Again, dragging that left shoulder back and down as much as possible. Maybe grab on to your left calf, draw your leg in. If this is in your practice, don't feel like you have to. Inhale, that left knee in. Exhale down to the end of the mat. Good job. Draw your legs in. Place your hands behind your thighs. Spinal rolls from shoulder to tailbone and back again, allowing each vertebra to come back into alignment. We'll do three or four of these. And arrive at the tops of our mats in Sukhasana, simple seated pose, crisscross applesauce. Good job. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that right leg. Draw that left heel in. We're moving into gatekeeper. Place your hands on your knees. Inhale that left arm up and over as you slide that right arm down. Again, into gatekeeper, finding those right toes if this is in your practice. Opening up those left obliques as we do. Inhale, back to center. Exhale first. Inhale, both arms all the way up. And exhale, as you fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down, hearts come down. Third eye comes down. Again, in humbly bowing gatekeeper, breathing in and out. Again, perhaps rock that third eye back and forth on the mat. Open up your third eye, your intuition as you do. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk them to the left. Grabbing onto your left knee with your right hand. Bringing that left hand back, dragging your shoulders back and down. Twisted gatekeeper. Inhale, that left arm up and over. Find your right toes once again. In twisted Dandasana. Excuse me. Twisted Chanyushasana. Inhale, that right shoulder through, and exhale down, shin to shin, in Janyarshasana. Again, maybe place that left hand on your left kidney as you do, puffing the breath into your kidney, keeping it healthy. And again, smile. It's Wednesday. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you bend that right knee. job. Inhale first. Exhale as you extend that left leg. Again, flex your foot. Sorry, we have some landscaping going on right now, and I'm just hoping it's not going to get too noisy. Inhale, both arms all the way up. Exhale, fold forward, hinge at the hips, reach, 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 reach. Fingertips come down, hearts come down. Again, maybe your third eye comes down, rocking it back and forth, opening your intuition as you do. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Exhale as you walk your hands to the right. Sorry, this noisy chainsaw behind me. Again, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale. That right arm up and over. Find those left toes. Again, in twisted Janya Shirshasana. Then inhale, that left shoulder through. Exhale, down to traditional Janya Shirshasana. Again, perhaps placing that right hand over your right kidney as you do. Breathing in and out. Inhale back to center. And then exhale as you bend your knee. Hard to concentrate with this noise. I hope that it's not bothering you. I think this is going to be the loudest that it gets, though, because I think they're cutting a tree right beside the casita. From here, let's go ahead and inhale both arms all the way up, inhaling gratitude. And exhale down to Anjali. Kind of funny, they were supposed to come on Saturday and it rained for the first day pretty much ever, which was very exciting for everybody, but it would have been nice to have it done on Saturday. Inhale both arms all the way up, inhaling gratitude, and exhale down to Anjali. One more time, inhale all the way up. And exhale down to Anjali Mudra. Good job. And then from here, place your fingertips on the mat. Inhale that right arm up. Bend your elbow as you exhale, placing the palm of your hand in between your shoulder blades. Inhale, that left arm up. Grab your elbow and exhale over to the left. Again, opening up that right shoulder, your whole right side. Looking up towards the right eye. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, down. Inhale, that left arm up. Exhale as you bend your elbow, placing your hand in between your shoulder blades. Inhale, that right arm up. Grab your elbow and exhale over to the right, looking up towards the left. Good job. Inhale, both arms up. And exhale, down. Good job. Place your hands on the mat. roll up into table. And then in table, our shoulders are above our wrists, our hips are above our knees. And if we look between our legs, we shouldn't see our feet. Let's go ahead and inhale first to cow. Drag your spines down, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale as you bend those elbows, transitioning into cat. Inhale to cow. Exhale to cat, dragging your spines up, gazing at your navels. One more time, inhale to cow. And exhale to cat, good job. And then from here, come back to a flat back. Inhale that right arm out. Left leg goes back. Flex your foot. We're in sunbird. And again, in sunbird, this is a balanced position. Looking gently out about 6 feet beyond. Exhale as you draw your elbow to your knee. Inhale out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, out. Wrap that right arm around. Bend your knee. Grab onto your ankle. Pull up into modified dancer. Modified bow pose. Good job. Exhale down. Inhale that left arm out. Right leg goes back. Flex your foot. Again, we're in sunbird, looking gently out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale out. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale out. Wrap that left arm around. Bend your knee. Grab onto your ankle. Pull up into modified dancer. Modified bow pose. And smile. It's Wednesday. Exhale down, good job. And then from here, bend your, or curl your toes under, bend your toes under. Sit back on your heels. Make infinity symbols with your wrists. Opening up your wrists. Opening up your toes and your ankles. Breathing in and out. Draw those arms overhead in the Uttita if this is in your practice. Shoulders back and down. Pelvis comes in as you do. And then draw those arms behind you. Touching your fingertips. Fingertips move up towards the crowns of your heads. Interlace your thumbs in Anjali Mudra behind your back. Breathing in and out, shoulders back and down. Good job. Two, one. Rock forward on your elbows. Slap out your feet. Good job. Then tuck in your shirts. Plant the palms of your hands into the mat. Curl your toes under. Inhale first. Exhale back to down dog. Again, maybe walking your dog, maybe not. Wherever you are is perfect. Again, dragging your hearts towards your thighs, breathing in and out. Again, perhaps lifting first one heel and then the other, dragging the other heel down towards the mat. Good job. And then from here, inhale that right leg all the way up. Three-legged dog split, flex your foot. Exhale as you swing it through to a lunge. Good job. Plant that back foot, 45 degree angle. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana one, warrior one. Looking up towards your third eye, pinky fingers are in. Exhale, Virabhadrasana two. Again, looking towards your future. Your body is in the present. And your left arm is in the past. Good job. Look, reach, 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 reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Open up those right obliques. Then exhale back. Straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Pull that left hip back, right hip forward. Float those arms back up again. Reach, 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 as far as you can. And then burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Again, look up, see your thumb, make sure you're not torquing. Then bend that right knee, coming into side angle. Rotate that left arm around and forward, pointing towards your third eye. Feel that energy coursing from the left side of your foot all the way up to your fingertips. Good job. Come back to center, north and south. Take a wrap. Possibly take a bind, grab on wherever you can. Again, in bound side angle. Open up once again. Look towards the front of the mat. Launch off of that left foot. Plant that right hand into the mat in front of you or the floor. Coming into Ardha Chandrasana. And again, as we're in Ardha Chandrasana, maybe take a bind if this is in your practice. Don't feel like you have to. Open up once again. Look down. Bend that right knee. Tip yourselves back to Virabhadrasana 2. Again, warrior 2. If you're on the mat, look down, inhale up to Virabhadrasana 2. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that right leg all the way back. Three-legged dog split. Go through your vinyasa, bending those elbows. Inhale up to cobra or up dog. Exhale back to down dog. Inhale through your noses, sigh it out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. Good job. Inhale that left leg all the way up, three-legged dog split. Exhale as you swing it through. Plant that back foot, 45-degree angle. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana, one on the left side. Good job. Exhale as you transition into Virabhadrasana, two. Make sure that that back foot is parallel to the front of the mat. Reach, 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 reach. Palm up. Exalt that warrior. Lift your hearts to the sky. Good job. Exhale back. Straighten your front leg. Place your hands on your hips. Pull that right hip back, left hip forward. Again. Float those arms up. Reach, 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 reach. And burst into Trikonasana, triangle pose. Good job. And then from here, bend that front knee, coming into side angle. Rotate your right arm around and forward into the Uttita. Feeling that energy coursing from the right side of your foot up through your fingertips. Draw your arm back to center, north and south. Take a wrap. Maybe take a bind. Wherever you are is perfect. Dragging that right shoulder down towards the mat. Open up, north and south. And then from here, look out beyond your mat. Launch off of that right foot. Plant your left hand. And then flex that right foot as you lift it into Ardha Chandrasana, standing half moon. Maybe bend your knee, grab onto your foot in a bind. If this is in your practice, don't feel like you have to. And then gently bend that left knee as you release your foot, coming back to Virabhadrasana two. If you're on the mat, look down. Inhale up to Virabhadrasana two. Cartwheel those arms down. Kick that left leg all the way back. And go through your vinyasa. Or meet us in down dog. Again, walking the dog, breathing in and out. And then from here, come up on your tippy toes, bend your knees, look towards the front of the mat, step or jump up. Inhale, halfway up to Ardha. Looking towards the front of the room, flattening out your backs, shoulders back and down. Making space in Ardha Tadasana. Exhale down to Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Inhale halfway up to Ardha Tadasana. Exhale down to Uttanasana. Slightly bend your knees. Inhale all the way up. Swan dive backward. Hands come together. Slight back bend. And hands come to Anjali Mudra. Bowing our heads in honor of our practices. Good job. Let's move into some balance positions. So we're starting in Tadasana, mountain pose. Again, all four corners of your feet are growing into the earth. Lift your toes, calf muscles moving inward, thighs are moving inward, shoulders down the back. Crowns of your heads are moving up towards the heavens, pelvis is in, hands are open to receive. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that right tippy toe. Draw your right heel to your left ankle, to your left calf, or to your left thigh. Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale those arms up overhead into Talasana or palm tree. Utthita, hands come together. And exhale down, good job. Draw your knee to a marching position, flex your foot. Inhale those arms up into stork. Utthita, and down. Good job, inhale first, hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down, good job. Shake it out. Starting in Tadasana once again, mountain pose. Feel that mountain within you. Draw your hands to Anjali Mudra. Come up on that left tippy toe. Draw your left heel to your right ankle, to your right calf, or to your right thigh. Again, Vrikshasana A, B, or C. Inhale those arms up overhead into Talasana or palm tree. Utthita, and down. Draw your knee to a marching position, flex your foot. Inhale those arms up overhead. Again, into stork. Hands come together in the Utthita. And exhale down. Inhale first. Hold it, hold it, hold it. And exhale down. Good job. Shake it out. Come up to the tops of your mats. Inhale both arms all the way up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, halfway up. Take a giant step back with your left foot. Walk that right foot all the way across. Right knee down, left top of foot down. Moving into resting pigeon. Inhale, as you come into Venus Mudra, if this is in your practice. And gently exhale forward. Again, humbly bowing yourselves, coming down onto that left cheek if this is in your practice. If not, it could be your right cheek. It could also be your elbows. Wherever you are is perfect. Again, maybe drawing those hands towards the front of the room, opening up your shoulders, but don't feel like you have to. Make sure that you draw your hands back towards your waist before you release. Keep your shoulders safe. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Coming off on that right hip, swing that left leg all the way around. Left foot is parallel to your right thigh. Bring that right foot in and that right elbow in. Inhale that left arm up and around. Find that right hip crease. Maybe take a bind, breathing in and out. Again. Drag those shoulders back and down in the Marjanasana twist. Opening up. Twisting our internal organs, releasing toxins. Inhale back to center. Release your legs and shake them out. Come come up to the tops of your mats in Malasana, yogi squat. Again, shoulders back and down. You can stay here or come up on those tippy toes, rocking back and forth. Coming in to Bakasana or crow pose. I just want to give a shout out to Devin today. It was his angelversary yesterday. We didn't have class yesterday, but I am thinking about him as I do Bakasana. Raven position, breathing in and out. He always brings a smile to my face. You can stay there or come back with us into Malasana. Inhaling from your root chakra all the way up to your crown chakra. And exhaling down again. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Place your hands on the mat. Inhale halfway up to Ardha. Take a giant step back this time with your right foot. Walk that left foot all the way across. Left knee down, right knee down, right top of foot down. Inhale as you walk those hands back. Take Venus Mudra. And exhale down, coming down onto that right cheek. Again, breathing in and out. I do apologize for those chainsaws. Again, dragging those wrists towards the center of the room as much as possible to open up your shoulders if you'd like to. Or gently bring them back towards your waist and release. Make sure that you keep your shoulders safe. Inhale as you walk those hands back again. Again, coming off on that left hip, swing that right leg all the way around. Right foot is parallel to your left thigh. Bring that left foot in and that left elbow in. Inhale that right arm up and around. Find your left hip crease. Possibly take a bind if this is in your practice. Shoulders back and down. In the Mariandrasana twist. Again, opening your hearts to the sidewall through the breath. Inhale, back to center. Exhale as you extend those legs and shake them out. Bend your knees. Arms are out on either side of your knees. Inhale first. Exhale, inch by inch. Vertebra by vertebra, down to the mat. And when you get there, draw those knees in for a much deserved hug. Rock back and forth, massage your lower backs and your kidneys. And then from here, take your block, which might be next to you, hopefully. Place your heels just below your sit bones. Inhale, as you push your hips up, placing the block underneath your sacrum on the highest, second, or third levels, wherever you are, is perfect. Again, opening up your lower backs, maybe walk those feet forward. Possibly draw your arms overhead. Wherever you are is perfect. Draw those arms back overhead, walk your feet in. Inhale as you push your hips up, release the block, and exhale down. Draw those knees in for a hug. And then from here, we're going to do legs straight up. If this is in your practice, you can also move in to a shoulder stand, walking your shoulders under as much as possible, looking like a candlestick. Feet are in Barbie feet. Slowly draw those toes overhead into Halasana or plow pose. Again, only if this is in your practice, be gentle with yourself. And then bend your knees, placing your knees around your ears in ear pressure pose or snail pose. And then inch by inch, vertebra by vertebra, coming down to the mat. Draw those knees in for a hug, rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. Inhale first, exhale as you extend that right leg. Inhale your left arm up overhead. Exhale as you push that left knee over to the right, look over your left shoulder. And breathe again. Full body twist. Inhale back to center, draw those knees in for a hug. And exhale that left leg down. Inhale your right arm up overhead. And exhale as you push your right knee over to the left. Look over your right shoulder and breathe. Inhale back to center. Draw those knees in for a hug. Rock back and forth. Massage your lower backs and your kidneys. Good job. Inhale through your nose, side out. Inhale. One more time. Inhale. And with that intention, allow your legs to come out as wide as the mat or wider. Arms are down beside your torso. Palms are up to receive, down to ground. Starting to relax. Relax your toes, relax your feet, relax your ankles. Relax your calves, relax your knees, relax your thighs. Relax your hips, relax your torsos, relax your fingers. Relax your hands, relax your wrists, relax your forearms. Relax your elbows, relax your upper arms, relax your shoulders. Relax your necks, relax your jaws, relax your cheeks. Relax your foreheads. Relax the crowns of your heads. Just relax. Start to bring movement back to your fingers and your toes by wiggling your toes and maybe touching each finger with your thumb. Draw your arms overhead. Extend through your feet, giving yourselves a full body stretch and filling your lungs with your breath. Then exhale as you draw those knees in for one final compassionate hug, rocking back and forth, massaging your lower backs and your kidneys. Slowly roll over to the right side in the fetal position and remain here for a few breaths. Then using the strength of your arms, come back to a seated position. Facing the front of the room, legs are crossed, hands are in Anjali Mudra, heads are bowed in honor of your practices. From the place deep in my soul that I know to be pure and true, I bow to and honor that same place that resides within each of you. Thank you so much for coming to practice yoga with me on this beautiful Wednesday. Again, remembering Devin on his belated angel date. I'm kind of amazed he was at a court date yesterday. Devin was helping out with that, and he was also at a wedding for his birthday this year. So his parents are very kind about sharing those events with others, and I feel very grateful for that. Thank you again for being here. I'll see you tomorrow, but not on Friday. Tomorrow I will be practicing yoga, but not on Friday. We're actually celebrating it then for my parents. It's a little easier for them. Namaste. I've got to get up to Prescott and cook. So, on Friday. So here we go. Thank you all for being here. I'm glad that you could. Let's see, I'll stop the recording.